Well, I recently did another video on potted motors where I revisited the rewiring of a potted motor out of my 15-91, which goes along with the potted motor series I did on the 201-2, the same motor essentially. And as a result of that revisit, which I did simply because I have better lighting now than I had back when I made that original video. Anyway, I had a question from Babette. She's working on her potted motor, and the potted motor, the hand wheels that are used with the potted motors, like this one, if you recall, there's two styles. There's one with the three retaining screws around the ring. There's also another one that uses an E-clip. Well, Babette's got this style one, and she's having a problem getting this ring off once all the screws are out. So this is the balance wheel that goes with my 1591. I haven't touched it yet, as you can tell by the level of crud and schmoo on it. So I figured, well, let's see if I can make this one have the same problems, or if this one has the same problems as Babette's, and I can show you how I get them off when they're a little stuck. So we'll start with taking out the three screws around the rim. Now, there's supposed to be, you can see here, there's some gap. There's supposed to be about 3/1000ths of an inch of clearance between this retaining ring and the Textilite gear. It looks to be as somebody has been in here before me, because there's a heck of a lot more than 3/1000ths of an inch clearance. And sure enough, this one's a little jammed. So what I'm going to do is to start with, I have a single edge razor blade. I'm just going to get through and just run the single edge razor blade all the way around in between the ring and the Textilite gear. That way, if there's any schmoo that's between the ring and the gear, that'll break that free. Then, taking the thinnest screwdriver blade I have, I'm going to go at the locations where those screw holes are. I'm just going to see if I can slide it in there and gently wedge it to get it to lift off. This one's going to come off easy now. But you see, if I go to lift it, it's still not going to come. But if I just go lightly, I can gently, and there, it comes off. And you can see the amount of schmoo inside there. And as we further dissect it, the filth factor is, nice. It looks like this washer is crud welded in place. Crud welding being a technical term for it. Yep, so once again, using the razor blade to cut through the crap. Being careful, of course, not to cut yourself, because that will never do. We don't want anybody to ever get hurt doing this. But slicing through the crud with the razor blade. There we go. Popped it off. It was stuck on that pin. It's coming out. Trying not to get my hands too dirty. I really don't feel like getting filthy this morning if I don't have to. And we'll use our tweezers and extract the eccentric pins. And that one's good and stuck in there. Yep, that is good and stuck. Try a little bit of croil on this. Let the croil sit there and soak in. There it goes. Roll it out. All right, now it's just a matter of cleaning up the parts. All right, now that we got the Textilite gear and all the other components cleaned, and all I used for the cleaning was I went to the sink, used hot water, a degreaser. In this case, I used Dawn dish soap, the blue stuff, for anybody who's really that interested. And some nylon scrub brushes. And I got all the crap off of everything. And then I did take the Textilite gear and the balance wheel out to my garage where I have a rather large air compressor. And I made sure everything was dried using about 60 pounds of air pressure from my of compressed air. But anyway, that's neither here nor there. It's time for reassembly. It's very simple. I use a little bit of the So Retro grease from the Featherweight shop, just a little bit. Put some on the pins and get the pins back in their bores. The purpose of these pins is to prevent the spring, which we'll be installing next, from banging up inside the hand wheel, making a lot of noise. Or as the singer calls it, the shock-absorbing spring. So let's get that second pin in and get it oriented reasonably correctly, which is to have the pin towards the bore of the hand wheel. And I'm going to put just a little dab of grease on this pin, I should say around this pin, and then just a little, just get it wet with grease going around. That goes on the left. The cover goes on, going over the pin. Oops. Going over the pin. There we go. Clicked on. Now we can check this loop here. You can see here we've got some bouncy bounce movement. That's what we want. The pin on the Textilite gear, we give it just a tiny amount of grease. That's weight. That's actually too much. And wipe some of that off. Okay, and that pin goes into that hole, into that loop, and you can see we have a snappy action. Now here's the interesting part. We put the retaining ring on. Now the retaining ring is just dropping in place because everything is clean. What we want is about 3/1 of an inch clearance between the ring and the Textilite gear. So I'm going to pull up an 003, which I'm sure I've got in my feeler gauge. I do. 003 is right here, which is also 0.076 millimeter. Let's just get this carefully. Now what we're going to do is we're going to start these screws first. I used a little, not a little doodad, just to get the screws going. Use the parts, the screw starter thingy. Just going to get the screws started. This makes it so much easier. Okay, so we got our screws going. Run that one down a little bit more. Now, we're going to put our 3/1 feeler gauge in. Just let that rest on there. Tighten that a little bit. Rotate. Get the feeler gauge underneath. And snug that up a little bit. Not super tight yet, just snug. And then last stop right here. Get our feeler gauge in. Snug it up, and now we can actually tighten these down a little bit more. Okay, we still have a good snappy action, as you can see here. And we still have our 3/1, actually we got a little bit more than 3/1 clearance, that's okay. 3/1 is the minimum clearance you want. And then when it gets time to put this back in the motor, we'll get some more grease on this Textilite gear. But I'm not going to put that grease on there now because the machine's not anywhere near being ready. although it's balance wheel and its motor is. Well, I hope that answers any questions you all might have had. Thank you all so much for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.